p.m.
And I got to talk to Kevin Rainey earlier today, and he gave me the teams that will be at the, or the kids, I should say, competing in that, whether the schools they'll be from in that Tuesday regional. So I'll get those names here, or those schools here momentarily. But a really pretty good day for Rochester Athletics.
Yeah.
The bowling team struggled a little bit.
Yeah.
Talked to D. Brown a little bit about that, and I don't think they finished as high as they expected to, but I know they had a very, very good season. So we are ready for the varsity contest, and B. Pollock controls the tip as she gets it to Murphy. And Murphy will walk it through the center circle, man-to-man defense by Manchester. Murphy drives into the lane, dump pass to Stasiak. Keaton backs away in, throws up a shot too hard, and the rebound to Manchester. Hacker gives off to Bedke, who gives ahead to Parrott. Paired a couple of dribbles. Rochester in at 1-3-1 zone, Brad. We've seen a lot this year. Becky left side to Hacker. Stands the ball above her head. Now top to Carter. Carter with the basketball. A couple dribbles this way.
Rochester usually facing a height deficit, and I don't know that that's the case tonight. It has
Betke buries one from about 15 feet and puts the Manchester Squires up 2-0 with 40 seconds gone here in the opening quarter.
But that's usually the reason for the zone, to try and offset that disadvantage.
1-17 of the Manchester Lady Squires. Keaton drives, foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. So Manchester up 2-0, and Keaton Stasiak for the Lady Zebras will be at the free throw line to shoot two free throws, looking to tie the score.
And Betke is the one that picked up the foul.
Stasiak with two. Keaton eyes it, flies it too hard. She'll have one more. One thing they did really well against Wabash is they got to the line.
Yeah, they did.
Unfortunately.
The one thing they've continued to struggle with is making that an advantage.
That's right. So Stasiak with one more for the Lady Zebras, looking to get them on the scoreboard here early in this game, and she does so by hitting 1-of-2. And it's 2-1 Manchester, and the Lady Squires of the basketball. And now they've switched it up to, looks like probably a half-court trap. Maybe here comes the jump. Betke is going to throw it away. So Rochester starts on the first series, the 1-3-1 zone, and then a half-court trap on the second possession for Manchester.
Well, sectional start next week, so you've got an entire repertoire of your playbook to go through.
Yep, might as well sharpen them all the tools.
Yeah.
Murphy runs the point against the man-to-man defense. Murph high on the left side with the basketball, still dribbling in the right hand. Looking down low, sends it right corner to Malco. She drives in the paint. Cut off by the defense. Gives to Pollock outside to Murphy. She one dribble to the left side, out top to X. Holland drives it. Lehner off the glass, partially blocked. Ball tipped around, and X stays from going out of bounds to Stasiak. Keaton drives it into the lane. She rises up, puts a shot up, and she's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Keaton Stasiak very aggressive here early on in this basketball game, and she'll go to the line for the second time tonight.
And Betke will pick up her second foul.
So it'll be interesting to see what Coach Ergood does here, as one of her guards just picked up, like Brad said, foul number two. So Stasiak with two freebies again for Rochester. First one is good. It falls through, and we're tied at two. One more coming for the sophomore. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Final game of the regular season for the Lady Zebras. Next action will be at John Glenn on Tuesday night in the second game of that sectional. Second one for the sophomore is good again, as she rattles it home. Keaton 3, Manchester 2. For Manchester basketball, Parrott gives to Becky, over the head pass to Snep. Snep cut off at the elbow, outside to Becky. Long three on the way from Manchester's in and out, no good. Rebound fought for. Murph comes out of there, rips it away from Parrott and runs. Murphy, left side of the floor for Rochester. At the free throw line, crossover dribble in the lane, goes to the back. She's fouled on the shot, and it'll be out of bounds. Actually, it's fouled before the shot. It'll be out of bounds to the Rochester Lady Zebras.
That foul's coming against Snep.
Manchester follow, number 23.
So, yeah, I'm guessing Murphy's probably got a green light to shoot tonight.
I would say so.
Murph, right there.
Murph in the corner. Fakes a three, top of the key to Malco. Becky on the volleyball line, drives it right, pulls it back outside, feeds B down low. Pollock in the paint against a double team. Out to Keaton. She rises up in the paint, off the back of the rim, and good. 5-2, Rochester, with 2 minutes gone here in the opening quarter. Here comes that half-court run-and-jump defense as well. Bedke gets it across over the top of the defense to Carter. Carter drives the baseline, throws the shot up over Stasiak, and the rebound comes down to Malco. Now gives the head to X. Rochester with the numbers. X, left elbow. Pull up, floating away from the basket. No good. Malco with the rebound. The layback up is good.
Becky Malco kind of trailing the play. was able to take advantage of that ball coming off on the opposite side and get the easy layup.
Rochester now in a 7-0 run as the pass goes down low to Steph, who loses it and is going to be tied up between she and X. As Manchester going to keep possession on the baseline left. Parrott looked to trigger it in. Parrott studies. Studies, bounce pass inside to Carter. Now right elbow pass to Hacker. Loses the handle. Ball loose. Still loose. Going to be tied up again. Rochester going to get it back. 5:19 to play first quarter. 7-2 Rochester. And the Lady Zebras of the basketball going to our left. Malco will walk it through the center circle. Man-to-man defense by Manchester. Left side to Holland. X gets a pick from Stasiak, rolls right side, now to Malco, three on the way, right wing, short, rebound, fall four, and Bedke for Manchester comes out of there with it. Bedke now runs for the Lady Squires, middle to four through the center circle, works left side to Hacker. Hacker now right wing to Carter. Carter will fire a three from downtown. It's good.
3 points. Manchester basket.
7-5.
Sierra.
Rochester's lead is cut to two with 4:40 to play in the first quarter. Malco accelerates in the paint. Dump pass down low to B. Shot off the window. Good. 9-5 Rochester. 4.5 to play in the first quarter. Bedke, gets it to Hacker. Hacker over the defense, tipped away by Pollock. B has it, she runs. B, left side of the floor. She goes to the basket hard and fouled before the shot. It'll be out of bounds to the Lady Zebras. I'm not sure. I could probably count on one hand the amount of times I've seen B. Pollock take the ball at the timeline and dribble to the...
tip away a pass at midcourt and take it in.
Yeah. So Rochester has it baseline left. Murphy quickly with the basketball, shoots a three. It's good! X caught Manchester sleeping, and Murphy made him pay.
We've seen her do that time and time again all season long.
B, almost another steal. Snap gets the basketball again, and she travels. Kenna Gillum into the game for the first time for Manchester, and she replaces Bedke, who has two personal fouls. 4:09 to play, first quarter, Rochester by 7. And the Lady Zebras of the basketball going to our left. Malco high on the right side. Gives it to Stasiak. Back to Malco. Bedke holds. No look pass to X on the near side. X accelerates to the baseline. Throws up a shot. And before the shot, it'll be out of bounds. And Rochester getting close to shooting free throws, Brad, for the rest of the half.
Yeah, they are. And that's the Hacker's second foul.
X will look to get it in again. Baseline left. Lobs it in to B at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Murphy. Murphy behind the arc on the right wing. She drives it. She's in the paint, and she is fouled on the reach in. It'll be 6 on Manchester.
And I think that's Hacker's third.
Coach Airgood is going to have to go to the bench, and you're right.
You know, we kind of saw a little bit of that in the JV game where North Manchester was getting wrapped up in the foul situation earlier in the game.
Murphy, make that X, 3, left side. Nope, too hard. Murphy with the rebound. On the baseline, putback is no good, but we're going to have a foul on the floor before the shot, but Murphy will go to the line to shoot one and the bonus for the Lady Zebras.
That foul's on Snap. That's her second. So at least they're consistent in the foul column, huh? Well, quit fouling
right out loud.
Yeah.
That was my thoughts exactly.
Selena Carter, the 5'6 junior, into the game for the first time, and Hacker to sit.
In case you missed that, it's 7-0 in the foul column.
Yeah, the Manchester fans are...
We're not happy, but I can't argue the call.
No, I can't either.
Also checking in.
Murphy hits the first free throw. She'll have one more. The score is 13-5 Rochester with 3:40 to play in the first quarter. Murph will have one more for the Lady Zebras. Eyes it. Flies it. Good. 9-point lead right now for the Lady Zebras and Manchester the basketball. As Bedke's back in the game, and she has her pass stolen by Malco. Malco, middle of the floor, now left elbow. Backs it back outside, and will reset for Rochester. Right side to Murph. Murph on the wing, looking down low to B. Lobs it into her. Shot is off the window, and good!
Well, you can give Pollock credit as well for the tipped-away pass that Malco
right
came
on.
Up with.
An 11-point lead for the Lady Zebras. A 60-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
And we're on.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets.
All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all
statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, the Lady Zebras just committed their first team foul. Here with 3:15 to play in the first quarter, Rochester up by 11.
Becky Malko picks up that foul.
Becky Malko.
The baseline left is Parrott, will look to trigger it in for the Lady Squires. Parrott studies. Got to hurry. Gets it in and stolen by Malko. Malko ahead to Holland. Holland, right-handed layup off the window is short. Rebound to Pollock here. Putback is good. B. Pollock with two more, and Rochester up 18-5. Parrott drives it. Throws it down low to Carter. Carter on the blocks, loses the handle, picks it back up, gives to Parrott. She drives in the lane, rises up over the defense, high off the glass, no good. Rebound to Pollock, who gives to Malko. Rochester runs. Malko high on the right side for the Lady Zebras. Slows up, gives to Murphy, top of the key, sings on the near side to Holland. X drives it to the free throw line, back outside to Malko. Malko in the paint. Out to Holland behind the arc, just inside the arc, a step. Her shot no good, short. And the rebound comes down to Holland as Abbott is in the game for the first time for the Rochester Lady Zebras.
Abbott keeping that rebound alive, yep, just enough for Holland to come back and pick it up.
2:25 to play, first quarter, 18-5 Rochester. Lady Zebras of the basketball going to our left. Murphy feeds Pollock deep into the lane, throws up a shot, it's good. That's tough to defend when B is that deep
it
in
is,
the paint.
Yeah, it's just a little turnaround jump shot from that point. She's got eight in the first quarter.
15-point lead for Rochester. Carter with the basketball, drives the baseline, goes to the basket, and throws it off the foot of her sister, Selena, and out of bounds.
That's the seventh turnover for Manchester.
And Keaton Stasiak back into the game for Rochester. Becky Malko to sit down. 2:04 to play in the first quarter. Rochester 20-5. And the Lady Zebras of the basketball, Murphy, will walk it through the center circle. Now drifts to the right side at the volleyball line. Now upside up to the three-point line. Backs away inside the three-point lane. Down low to B. B's fall away jumper in the paint. No good. And the rebound to Snep in Manchester. Quickly to Bedke. Ahead to Carter. Carter cut off in the baseline. Out to Bedke. Three on the way is off the mark. No good. And the weak side rebound to Pollock. B hauls in the loose ball. And now gives to Murphy, and Rochester up by 15 and runs. 90 seconds to play in the first quarter. Murphy in the paint. Leaner on the way. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Squire foul, number 40.
That foul is coming against Selena Carter, her first.
So Murphy back at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras.
Murphy.
With 1:27 to play in the first quarter. Murph. Eyes the first one, lets it fly, no good. Becky Malko back into the game and Holland to sit. I got a feeling, Brad, you're going to see a lot of this rotating in all night to keep them fresh.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be surprised if Tony doesn't start putting some of those JV players in early in that third quarter.
You're probably right. Murph eyes the second one, looking to push this lead to 16, and she does so. 21-5, Rochester, a minute 25 to play. In the first quarter, Manchester the basketball. Bedke out top, picks up her dribble against the double team now out to Parrott at the volleyball line. Parrott drives it right around Stasiak, picks up her dribble now, wrap around past the snap. Snap at the elbow, loses the handle, picks it up. Now to Parrott. Parrott, shot over Malko, rolls in.
Squire basket, number three, Caitlin.
And it's 21-7 with 60 seconds to play in the first quarter. Malko now runs a point against the man-to-man defense, works to the right wing, picks up her dribble, looks down low to B, but gives to Abbott on the elbow. Left side, to Stasiak. Keaton in the lane. Down low to B. Pollock jumper is short. And the rebound to Manchester. Nice move, but couldn't finish it.
Yeah, she probably should have took that off the glass. She tried to come over the side of the rim and rolled off the front.
You're right. Carter to Bedke. Bedke one dribble to Parrott. Parrott left side to Sierra Carter, and she loses the handle right into the hands of Abbott, and she gives to Murphy, and she brings it up the floor with 25 seconds to play in the first quarter. Murphy works left side, picks up her dribble, now bounce pass in the backcourt, saved from going in the backcourt by Keaton, who gives to Malco with 17 to play in the first quarter. Malco off to Stasiak with 13. Keaton holds with 12. Keaton now dribbles with 11. Keaton in the lane, goes to the basket, fouled on the shot, she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Well, that foul's coming against Bedke, and that's going to be her third. So Bedke and Hacker both with three fouls for Manchester here in the first quarter.
Keaton's first free throw here is good. 22-7, X back in, and Murphy to sit. 9 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester up 22-7. And Stasiak will have one more free throw for her Lady Zebras. Second on the way is short, and the rebound to Manchester. Bedke runs with five, crosses the timeline with four, and has a stolen by Malco. Bedke Malco with two, with one. Layup on the way is no good.
I'm not so sure she didn't travel. But
after one, Rochester leads 22-7. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Basketball, WROI.
Go here at Rochester. The Lady Zebras up 22-7. Manchester will start with the basketball. Again, we mentioned the two divers going on to the regional on Tuesday night at Penn. Second place today,
Morgan Tyler. And Allie Tyler.
Yep.
Tyler.
The other teams feeding into that regional is Chesterton, Concord, Crown Point, South Bend Riley, and, of course, the Warsaw sectionals as well. So congratulations to those two young ladies, and we appreciate Kevin Rainey sending that information to us.
Number 23, Sydney.
So Snap gets a basket for the Lady Squires.
So it's now 22-9. Rochester with the basketball. Works to the right side. Crossover dribble to Stasiak at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Malco. Bedke just inside the arc. Lob pass down little B. Pollock. Her jumper short. Gets a rebound. Knocked away. Ball loose. Going to be tied up. Rochester going to get possession. Man, Rochester, our guards are doing a great job feeding the post.
They are. They're getting a lot of good looks down low to B. Pollock, and she's gotten a lot of good shots at the basket, but she's managed to knock most of them down. The last two, though, have been kind of short.
Holland, lob pass into B. B brings it down to her waist. Now outside of Bailey Abbott. She'll fire a long jumper. No good. And the rebound to Manchester and Carter. Carter gives off to Thompson, who's in the basketball game for the first time. Also Howard in the game as well. Thompson's jumper is short. Pollock with the rebound. Good block out for B. And now gives off to Malco. Coach Stasiak says, let's push it. We're up 22-9. Let's go. Minute gone in the second quarter. Malco down low to B. B in the lane. Turnaround jumper off the glass. No good. Rolls around and falls off. And the rebound to Manchester. Murphy will come in the next opportunity, or probably will spell B.
I would think so, yeah. Looks like he's starting to get a little frustrated with those shots not falling.
Milam with the basketball to Carter. Baseline to Howard. Howard to Snep. Jumper from the free throw line is good. So it's 4-0 run right now in the second quarter for Manchester. And it's 22-11. A lot of JVers on the floor right now for the Squires. Malco throws up a shot in the paint. No good. A lot of contact, no foul. Rebound to Manchester. And quickly on the run is Thompson. And she travels.
That's the 10th turnover now for Manchester.
Murphy back in, and V. Pollock to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 6:23 to play first half. 22-11 Rochester, and the Lady Zebras of basketball going to our left. Now coming up at the end of this game, we're going to be talking, of course, to Coach Stasiak. Good wraparound pass to Malco. Stasiak's fouled on the shot. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. And anyway, to finish that thought, we're going to obviously talk to Coach Stasiak about this game, and we'll also have both seniors, B. Pollock and Carly Murphy, who will be joining us in the postgame show as well.
Great.
Yeah. So Stasiak at the free throw line for two. First one of the way for sophomores. Too hard, no good. She'll have one more.
They already made her fourth trip to the free throw line in this ballgame.
I just enjoy watching Tony's reaction.
Watching the dad watch his daughter shoot free throws.
Second on the way for Keaton is good this time. 23-11. Rochester on top with 6:14 to play in the first half. Steph gets it to Thompson. Right side to Carter. Long three is no good. And Steph with the rebound. Hey, she has it stripped away by Stasiak. But right into the hands of Howard. Steph, turnaround jumper's good.
That's Steph's third basket in this second quarter.
Really? Okay.
She's got all six of their points.
Leads back to 10. And then X throws it out of bounds.
And I think this is what Coach Stasiak was worried about. Get up to a big early lead against a team that you know you're better than.
Yep.
And suddenly you start losing your concentration. You start getting sloppy.
Yep.
And that's not what you want 4 days before your first sectional game.
And I don't care what John Harrell says.
Yeah.
I'm saying John Glenn is the favorite.
Playing on their home floor with a 15-3 record, you got to think.
Yeah. And all of a sudden, Thompson just hit the three and cuts this to a 7-point lead, and Rochester will use his 30-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Minutes to play in the first half. Rochester up now 23. I should say only up now 23-16.
Yep.
It was a 16-point lead.
Manchester on 9-1 run.
Yeah. And that's basically coming from one full-time varsity player in Snip and a lot of JVers.
You're right.
Rochester the basketball to their 30-second timeout. Malco in the lane. Down low to Abbott. Her layup is good.
The basket number 24.
25-16. 9-point lead again for Rochester. Thompson through the center circle for the Lady Squires. Works the left side. The give and go down low to Thompson. Or make that to Howard. Stolen away by Malco. Malco on the way to the basket. Layup is short. And the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton loses it to Malco. Layup good.
Basket number 20.
And the lead is back to 11 with 5 to play in the first half.
Go.
Here comes a run and jump defense. Down low to... who was that? Number 12 is Milam. Her jumper's no good. Keaton Stasiak with the rebound. Gives off to Malco. Down low to B. Out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Rochester.
Yeah.
And they go back to Manchester.
That's B. Pollock too, didn't it? You know, I think Tony, Coach Stasiak is trying his darndest to keep his game in the half court. You know, he's not coming out with the full court pressure. He's not doing the half court trapping.
Milam has it stolen from behind. Ball loose. Abbott falls on it. Ball still loose. Now Murphy has it somehow. Murphy works left side. She loses the handle. Picked up by Carter. Carter runs the length of the floor. Layup is good and a foul.
Chester basket number 52, Sierra Carter.
Sierra Carter will go to the line to shoot one free throw for Manchester. Looking to cut this lead to 8. Sierra Carter is a 5'7 freshman. She's at the line for one. First one is going the way and good. 27-19 Rochester. Holland back in. Murphy to sit. Sharp as sharp could be. First quarter.
Yeah.
We've kind of drifted a little bit here in the second. Malco through the center circle. Man-to-man defense. Malco at the elbow left. Feeds down low to Abbott. Ball loose on the floor. Still loose. And Snip comes out of there with it and gives to Milam. Milam runs for Manchester. Milam, middle of the floor for Lady Squires, outside to Thompson. Now to Snip, left wing. Snip, long three on the way, and before the shot, we have a travel.
Well, Tony's always been a stickler for trying to get the ball working in down low. And I think tonight, with it being senior night, the girls have probably bought into that a little bit more than they have in the past.
Yeah, I agree.
And from a Manchester standpoint, like he touched on in the pregame, they got nothing to lose, and they know that's what Rochester's going to do.
Yeah. Yeah,
and they've done
right.
a pretty good job in this second quarter of trying to take that option away.
Well, I think that you can tell they have nothing to lose mentality by the lineup that's on the floor for them.
Mm-hmm.
As they
three starters are out of the game.
Yeah, you're right. Stasiak misses the basket, and Milam quickly up the floor to Howard. Howard to Thompson, just inside the arc. Her jumper is too long, and Stasiak with the board. Keaton now, with a little help from Snep, gives off to Murphy. Murphy against the man-to-man defense, drives it right. Picks up a dribble behind the three-point line. Stands the ball with above her head. Now to Stasiak. Keaton with the basketball with 3:20 to play in the first half. Rochester up by 8 at 27-9.
And we see Keaton Stasiak running the point again.
Yeah, we've seen that last three games in a row. Mm-hmm. X for three is no good. And the rebound to Manchester, and they are doing a great job while the Lady Squires is shutting Rochester down to just one and done.
You're right. I think when Stasiak has the ball on the point, that allows Holland to work without the ball in her hand and do a better job of getting open for those three-point shots.
I agree. Step for three, no good. B with the rebound, gives to Malco. Rochester runs under three to play in the first half, up by eight. Malco will drive all the way to the baseline. Now gives to Holland. X throws the shot up, no good. A lot of contact, no foul. Step with the rebound. And now to Thompson. Dribbles through the center circle, runs it right down the middle of the floor for Manchester. Outside to Milam. Milam back to Thompson. Fakes the three, gives in the corner to Howard. Her 15-footer is good. 27-21. Manchester has a Rochester lead down to six with 2:20 to play in the first half. Malco stops in the paint, rises up off the window and good.
Number 20.
And the lead is back to eight at 29-21. Thompson is going to be fouled in the back. Oh, no,
nope.
She's going to travel. So B. Pollock forces the turnover, and Rochester going to get it back up by eight with 2:05 to play in the first half. Malco runs the point for Rochester. She'll work against Thompson in the backcourt. At the volleyball line, gives to Holland on the right side. X for three. Yep.
And Alexa Holland gets herself in the scorebook with a timely three-pointer.
And pushes the lead back to double digits. Ooh. Milam with the basketball, and then she's going to be fouled on the reach-in by either Holland or X. Whoa.
Deep Holland going to pick up her first.
And gives the referee a little attitude.
I think he has back turned.
Yeah, I think that's probably a good idea. Thompson, bounce pass into Milam. Milam, oh boy, X probably should have picked up foul number two, and now B's going to pick up a foul.
Yeah.
.142 to play in the first half. Rochester up 32-21. And the Lady Squires have the basketball on the far side. Carter will look to get it in. Does so to Thompson, who crosses the timeline. Works it right side against Holland. Picks up the dribble. B, another steal. And now we're going to have a foul coming against Carter. And that's going to send B. Pollock to the line to shoot two.
Carter going to pick up her second.
Sierra Carter.
Then at 36 to play in the first half. Rochester by 11. B at the line to shoot two. Looking for double digits now.
Yeah, she's got eight.
B ready. Let's the first one fly. No good. One more coming for the senior.
The Lady Z's were 7 of 10 from the line in the first quarter, which is fantastic.
Absolutely.
For the way they've been shooting this year.
B ready. Eyes the second one, lets it fly. Good, good, good this time. 33-21 Rochester, 90 seconds to play in the first half. Thompson across the timeline. A couple of dribbles. Here comes a run and jump defense over the top to Snep. Snep takes it all the way down to the block. Leaner on the way is no good. Murphy the rebound. Rochester runs. Murph middle of the floor. And now Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's blow up. And then a great pass down little Pollock. Her jumper's good.
A one-handed off-the-dribble pass by Murphy from the top of the key down low to Pollock on the blocks for an easy shot.
Carter with the basketball on the far side. Dribbles away from trouble. Gives top of the key to Milam. 35-21. Rochester on top. And Holland picks the pocket of Manchester. Alexa Holland, left-handed layup. No good.
Yeah, and then Malco comes over the back on the rebound.
So Malco's
going to pick up her second foul.
56.9 to play in the first half. Rochester by 14.
Collins should have pulled up from 20. He was too close. We've seen her knock down some shots out here by the volleyball line, I'm telling you. She was 20 feet too close to the basket.
Thompson to the basketball. Down low to Carter. Gives him the baseline to Howard. Back to Thompson. Quick three for Manchester. Nope. And the rebound. Fall four out of bounds. Last touch by Manchester. Rochester going to get it back with 44.8 to play in the first half. The Rochester, the basketball, looking for the final shot of the period.
That's just my opinion. It may not be Coach Stasiak's idea.
Malco from the elbow, no good. Step with the rebound. She rips and gives to Thompson. Thompson runs for Manchester with 25. And then her pass is picked off by Abbott, who gives to Malco. Becky now slows up, and Coach Stasiak wants the final shot of the half. 35-21 Rochester. We're down to 15 seconds. Malco dribbles at the volleyball line with 12. Becky backs away to the 10-second line with 9. Now to Murph with 8. Murph works left side with 6. Murph, leaner on the way, is no good, but a foul coming on Manchester. And Murph will go to the line to shoot 2 with 5 seconds of play in the first half. Snep?
Yep, that's Snep's third.
23, Cindy Snep. At the line for the Zebras, shooting 2. Number 54, Carly Murphy.
Murph will have 2 for Rochester, up by 14 right now. The first one of the way for the seniors, good as it rattles in. And Holland will replace Becky Malco in the ladies' Zebra lineup. Murphy with 1 more. 5 seconds. Looking to push this lead back to 16, which would be the biggest lead of the game, or match the biggest lead of the game for the ladies' Zebras. Second one for the seniors, good again. 37-21 Rochester, 5 to play, 5 seconds to play in the first half. Carter has it with 2. Carter has it with 1. Not going to get a shot off. At halftime, Rochester leads 37-21. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I'll keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle. RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Side of the floor for the Lady Zebras. It's a crossover dribble in the paint. Leaner off the glass. Good as it rattles in.
Murphy now with 10.
That three? Pardon? Is that three in doubles? No.
Just two right now.
Badke with the basketball. Rochester in a little man-to-man press. Crosses the timeline. Picks up a dribble to volleyball 9. Now right side to Hacker. Goes to the baseline. Good defense by Stasiak. Kicks it outside to Snep. She takes feet to the rack. Loses the handle, but we're going to have a reach-in foul, I believe, on Stasiak. It'll be out of bounds to Manchester.
Stasiak going to pick up her first. Really, for Rochester, Malco with 2, and that's it as far as foul trouble.
Parrott gets it in to Carter. Right wing just inside the arc to a down low wide open. Parrott, her jumpers get off the baseline. And it's 39-23 with a minute gone in the third quarter. Rochester basketball going to our right. Malco through the center circle, works left wing. Now takes it all the way down to the elbow. Outside now to Stasiak on the baseline. Keaton drives off the window. Good. 41-23. Full court press by Rochester. Carter over the top to Parrott. Parrott across the timeline right for Manchester. Drives it all the way to the elbow. Now to the baseline. Outside to Hacker. She'll fire the 18-footer. It's no good. Draws nothing but air. And Pollock picks up the rebound and gives it to Murphy. Murphy now pushes ahead to Malco. Rochester up 41-23, 6.5 to play, third quarter. Malco works right side, caught off by the defense, now in the paint, fakes the shot, and she travels.
Yep.
Rochester will use a timeout. It is a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Cutting Edge in Rochester. You'll find really huge savings this time of year. And in February, take 30% off all backpacks and duffel bags in the back of the store and 30% off all Under Armour apparel. They offer in-store specials and they have the equipment, backpacks and duffels for your favorite sport. They carry major apparel brands including Under Armour, Russell, Adidas, and many, many more. So visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique, custom options and friendly service from the winning edge, Ryle Place Drive in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6.5 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 41-23, full court press. Bedke gets it, almost across the timeline. Stopped right near it. Ball's loose. X dies for it. Ball's still loose. Stasiak on the floor. X on the floor. And they can't save it from going out of bounds. It'll stay with Manchester.
Yeah, I'm going to give both teams a turnover. How's that?
Really?
Yeah. Manchester had it. Lost it. Rochester had it.
Never had it.
Threw it away.
Good grief.
Stasiak threw it out of bounds. That means she had possession.
Right? No.
Yeah.
I think she tipped it out of bounds. And now we're going to have a tie-up, and then Rochester going to get it back between Stepp and Holland. 6:16 to play in the third. That's a turnover.
I got it.
Did you mark? Okay.
Yeah. That's their 19th turnover for Manchester. Wow. Yeah.
41-23 Rochester. Lady Zebras of the basketball. Malco.
Unofficial, of course.
Right. Tries to feed it down low to Stasiak. Ball loose again. B picks it up. Now to Holland. X top of the key. Now left side to Malco. Wide open three. Left side. No good. Too hard. And the rebound to Parrott for Manchester. Parrott leads ahead to Carter. Carter against Pollock. Layup is good. 41-25 Rochester. 5:50 to play in the third quarter. Again, the final game for both of these squads. Final regular season game, I should say. Malco steps back, throws up a shot off the window. Nope. Pollock with a rebound. B is going to be fouled on the shot.
And I thought he's probably good. Lucky she didn't get called with a charge.
Well, okay. And I was also thinking of a tie-up.
Right.
Number three.
So it'll be out of bounds to Rochester, baseline right.
Parrott picks up her first, team first of the half.
X studies. To Murphy, fakes a three, drives it, pull-up jumper from 10 feet, way too hard, and the rebound to Hacker. And then Hacker is fouled by Stasiak, who, when Keaton turned around to run, she was right there.
Ran right into
it. Yeah, it was an unfortunate thing for Stasiak. Yeah.
Stasiak picks up her second.
The full court press for Rochester.
They called that on Pollock.
Oh, Pollock? She wasn't even around. Carter gets it ahead to a wide open Hacker and loses it out of bounds. They call that on Pollock?
Yeah, that's Pollock's second.
Huh. Apparently nobody, Coach. She was wide open. So Rochester has it back, 41-25. Holland through the center circle. Works right side against Carter at the elbow. Kicks it out to Murphy on the wing behind the arc. Murph studies. Law pass down to B. Good feed. Good. No good to the shot. As back out of bounds by Stasiak. Man, that was a great feed inside the bean. She couldn't finish it.
Again, she's just not getting anything off the glass to come through the net. Hitting the rim and bouncing away.
Parrott gets it into Snap. Snap against a double team. Dribbles away from it. And has it stolen by Malco. Ball loose. B picks it up. Now we're going to have a scrum. And Parrott and B is tied up. And Manchester going to get it back after a turnover.
Pollock's got to be careful. I don't know if she's aware that they called her on that foul that Stasiak committed.
Is that two?
That's her second.
Okay.
So
I'm not sure Coach Stasiak knows that.
Well, the rest of the bench does because I heard them arguing about it. So.
Parrott gets it in, but we're going to have a push-off foul on Hacker. Is that right? Of course, we're watching everything to our right, and that happened to the left of us.
That's her fourth. Team second.
So Murphy will look to trigger it in on the far sideline. Murph still looks. Bounce pass into Stasiak. Keaton holds near the timeline. Now we'll run the point against Parrott. Crossover dribble works left side. Gets a pick from Murphy. Now to Holland. X step back behind the three. Thought about a three. Passes it up. Now to Stasiak. Keaton down low to Murph. Murph backs away and against Hacker. Throws up a shot. It's good. 18-point lead for the Lady Zebras with 4:40 to play in the third quarter.
12 now for Murphy.
Carter has her pass stolen by Malco, and she's going to be fouled on the reach-in. Is Malco. And Carter going to pick up that foul with 4:37 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 43-25.
Carter's third.
I thought the bench players for Manchester late in that first half played really well.
Yeah, I would agree with you.
Malco fakes a three in the paint, cut off by the defense. Left baseline pass to Murphy. She'll take the 15 footer. It's good.
That's Murphy's sixth point in this quarter.
20-point lead for Rochester. Now Rochester's press is causing havoc a little bit as Bedke has it against a double team. Gives the head to Hacker on that far sideline. Now head to Parrott. Parrott across the timeline to Carter. She'll take the 16 footer. Right side is good. Good looking shot by Sierra Carter, a freshman for the Lady Squires.
She just scored her 10th point.
Yeah, she's had a good game to this point. Malco, a couple of dribbles. Picks her way through the defense. Feeds down low to Murph. Murph against Hacker. Leaner, no good. Gets a rebound. The putback is good.
That's 16 for Murphy, 8 in this quarter.
47-27. Rochester on top, and they force a 5-second count. And Bailey Abbott will come back in for the game for the Rochester Zebras, and B. Pollock will sit down. And Coach, the Manchester coaching staff will call a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farm Store of Rochester and Plymouth is your locally owned winter headquarters. With all the snowfall we've had in our area this winter, birds and ground-feeding wildlife need a little extra help this time of year. And Smith Farm Store has a way to help. Pick up a 50-pound bag of sunflower seed for just $19.59. All flavors of Heath suet cakes, just 99 cents. They have deer feed and salt blocks available, too. Take advantage of Last Chance, 70% off Christmas decorations and 50% off all toys in store. Stop by and see their helpful staff at Smith Farm Store with two locations in Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:44 to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 20 right now at 47-20. And after the Manchester timeout, Lady Zebras will have the basketball baseline right as X looks to get it in. Holland throws it to, let's see, is that Maddie? Maddie Hyatt on the Rochester bench.
That's
not a foul.
Who you threw it to. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Intended for Malco.
I think. Carter over the top of the defense to Parrott. Parrott holds, no dribble yet, over the top of the defense to Bedke. Bedke, crossover dribble, middle of the floor, throws up a shot. It's no good. Rebound by Bedke, has it stripped away, but in doing so, Murphy commits the foul. Well,
so Murphy will pick up her second.
Rochester's got some things to work on come Monday to get ready for John Glenn.
Well, you knew Coach Stasiak could find a reason to have practice.
Oh, and there's a sectional going on Tuesday.
Yeah.
If that wasn't enough. 3.5 to play in the third. Rochester by 20. Parrott baseline left for Manchester. Parrott studies over the top of the defense. Carter. Carter drives. Just gives out the snap. Snap. We'll pull up from 15 feet. It's good. Sydney Snap, the 5'7 senior, connects on another one and cuts this lead to 18 as Malco trots it up the floor. Works against the man-to-man defense. Works to the right elbow extended. Down low to Murph. Murph against Hacker. Layup is good. Nice shot by Murphy. Knowing that Hacker's got four. Is that right? Four fouls?
Yes. So the 5'7 senior Murphy working the post.
Hacker shot no good. The putback by Snep is no good. The putback by Snep is no good. And Parrott with a rebound. She's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Four opportunities on that trip by Manchester.
Right. So that foul coming against Holland, her second, team's fourth.
Coming up Monday night, the Rochester guys are at home as they host the LaVille Lancers here at Rochester High School.
Dangerous team.
6 o'clock JV tip with about a 7:30 pregame here on WROI. Parrott's free throw is no good. She'll have one more. As Pollock will report back into the game, and Keaton Stasiak will come out. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Under 3 minutes to play in the third quarter, Rochester at 49-29. And Parrott will have one more for the Lady Squires. Parrott's second one on the way is good this time. Rochester by 19 with the basketball going to our right. Malco across the timeline left. She looks at Bedke in the man-to-man defense. Bounce pass to B. B looking down low to Murphy. Good job by Hacker cutting off that passing lane outside to Holland. Actually has been quiet in this game.
Yeah, she has.
Works left side. Now to Malco. Bedke drives it left. Cut off by the defense, down low to Murph. Murph turnaround jumper's good.
Murph, on the other hand, has not been.
Have a senior night, young lady.
20 points, 12 of which are here in this third quarter.
She's got all 12 of the Lady Zebras' points in the third quarter.
Hacker just about traveled to get to Bedke. Say that again.
No, I'm sorry. Stasiak had a bucket as well. She's got 12 of the 14.
Wow. I probably need to start paying attention to what you're saying a little bit more often than I do now.
Why start now? So who had that last bucket from Angela?
I don't know. I can't remember. I didn't. I was listening to you.
Why? Why would you do that?
Murphy at the free throw line.
Thank you.
Murphy kicks it out to Malco. High on the left side for the Lady Zebras. Looks down low, has a wide open Murphy, and her shot is blocked out of bounds by Manchester. That was a good pass. It goes from the left wing down to the right block, and it threaded the needle. Unfortunately, Murphy had about three or four hands in her face trying to shoot that.
That'll happen when you score 20.
Yeah, you're right. Murph to Holland, three, right baseline, in and out, no good. And Snep with the rebound. Snep gives the head to Bedke, and Manchester runs. 51-32, Rochester on top, 90 seconds to play in the third quarter. Snep, right side pass to Bedke behind the arc on the wing. Now top of the key to Parrott. Parrott holds against Holland. Works to the right side, now middle of the floor, outside to Snep. Snep drives against Bailey Abbott, and we're going to have a foul on the floor. Is that going to be against Abbott?
Sure is. So Abbott will pick up her first, team fifth.
Stasiak back into the game. Holland to sit down with 1:19 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 51-23. Parrott will look to trigger it in. Over the top of the defense, the Hacker works right side, now to Carter. Carter fakes a three, drives Murphy to the baseline, cut off by the double-team defense. And now her pass is stolen by Stasiak. Stasiak gives to me, now to Murphy. Minute to play, third quarter. Rochester by 19. Bedke drives it right side, cut off by the defense, looking down low to B, and then steps in front of the pass and throws it away and picks it off, I should say, now to Carter with 54. Carter outside to Parrott. Parrott, jumper from the elbow, good off the glass.
Squire basket number three.
51-34, 40 seconds of play in the third. Malcolm through the center circle, accelerates around the defense, looks down low to Pollock. B backs her way in. Throws it up over Snep. It's no good. Rebound fall for. Ball being tipped around, and Bedke comes out of there with it.
Pollock's going to pick up.
Yeah, Pollock clothesline Bedke. Stasiak hit the floor hard.
That's Pollock's third.
31 seconds to play in the third. Rochester up 51-34. And Manchester with the basketball going to our left. Bedke across the timeline. Has her pass picked off by Bailey Abbott. Great read by Bailey Abbott. And Murphy will look to, and Coach Stasiak will want the final shot of the period. Murphy works left side against Hacker. Throws up a shot, it's good. Yeah, if you can get it to go, just go ahead and shoot.
Wow.
She has 22.
Yes. 14 here in this quarter.
9 seconds. Carter is then hooked by B. Pollock, which is a four foul number four for the Rochester Lady Zebras. And Manchester will go to the line to shoot one in the bonus here with 5.4 to play. In the third quarter, Rochester at 53-34. Holland comes in and B will come out.
Checking back in with the Zebras, number 10.
Well, it's crucial to keep B. Pollock in the game.
Yeah, it is.
Because you need to recognize her as the end of the game gets closer.
I agree with that. As from a Manchester standpoint, though, is that's who you key on for Rochester's offense. Now that she's out, obviously Murphy with 22 is going to grab your attention.
You would think.
But besides Murphy and Pollock, there hasn't been anybody else tonight.
And that's okay tonight.
Yeah.
Carter for Manchester hits both free throws.
Let it come in, let it come in.
I guess my point is now with Murphy on the bench, everybody's going to be looking at Murphy.
Holland picks it up with five. Holland right side with three. Holland works left side to Murph. Long three at the buzzer. Good! 25 points after three for Murphy. The Lady Zebras back up by 20. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Rochester High School, and after a big, 25-foot jumper at the buzzer, Carly Murphy has 25 points and extends the Lady Zebra lead back to 20. And Rochester starts the basketball. Malco throws up a shot. It's a tough one. Stasiak with the rebound. The putback no good, but a foul coming on Manchester. And we are a quarter away from Coach Stasiak picking up his 200th career victory.
Bedke going to pick up her fourth. Yeah, that's a big milestone for Coach Stasiak.
Yeah, it's a big deal. You're right. And you know how long we'll talk about that? About that long. Stasiak's free throw good. Nothing but net. She'll have one more.
That's the third Lady Zebra in double digits tonight.
Man, Murphy is having a night. You just said
Stasiak and Pollock are the other two in double digits, and they still haven't scored as many as Murphy has by herself.
17 third quarter points for Carly Murphy. Yeah. Fantastic. As Stasiak hits both free throws at 58-36. Betke. Now Rochester back in a 2-3 zone. That's a zone. It's a running jump 2-3 zone. A half-court trapping 2-3 zone. Bedke around the defense. Now to Snep. Snep loses the handle. Ball loose. Gets it back. And gives outside to Parrott. Becky Malco slow to get up. Still slow to get up. Still trying to catch her breath. Manchester the basketball going to our left. Parrott around the defense. Ike almost steals it. Gives to Snep. Snep to Milam. Milam with Bailey Abbott in her grill. Throws up a shot. It's no good. Murphy the rebound.
Murphy rebound.
And Murphy brings it up the floor. Works to the right side. In the paint. Leaner off the glass. Why not?
Another 2 points for Carly Murphy.
Why not? And Bedke now quickly up for Manchester. 60-36, Rochester. Milam against a double team. Has her pass tipped away. Ball loose. Ball still loose. There's a scrum for it. Manchester comes out of there with it to Howard. Howard kicks it outside to Milam. She drives, pulls up from 15 feet. It's good.
Manchester basket number 12, L.A. Milam.
60-38.
Murphy's rebound.
And X high on the right side. Step back. Murphy at the volleyball line. Chuck it.
Just shoot it, young lady.
It's going in. Murphy works to the right wing. Feeds down low to Stasiak. Keaton backs her way in. Throws up a shot. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. And that foul coming against Milam for the Manchester Lady Squires.
This is the sixth trip to the free throw line for Stasiak.
Yeah, she was there for, she's the only one that's shooting free throws in the first quarter, I think. She was there a lot in the first quarter.
She was. Murphy had free throws in the first quarter as well.
Keaton free throws good.
Surprise, surprise.
B. Pollock into the game, and I'm guessing here, Brad, I'm just guessing.
Yeah.
B. Pollock and Carly Murphy's night just about done.
I would give you that another minute 22, something like that.
B's got to stay out of foul trouble.
Well, I think they're going to try and feed down to her on offense if they can.
Rebound by the miss by Keaton Stasiak. Rebound to Snep. And quickly Milam for Manchester. 6:15 to play in the fourth quarter. 61-38 Rochester. Ball loose. Murphy is going to tie up. Who is that? Bedke. And Manchester going to keep possession. Coach Aragood will go to the bench. And she'll bring back in Gillum. And she'll replace the Milam for the Manchester Lady Squires. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 6:10 to play in the game. Rochester up 61-38. Manchester with the basketball. Gillum. Left side to Parrott. Parrott works in the middle of the floor. 2-3 zone right now by the Lady Zebras. And Step watches it go through her hands and out of bounds. Murphy working on 7 rebounds tonight as well. Under 6 to play in the game. Rochester the basketball. Murphy will rock it through the center circle. Man-to-man defense by the Lady Squires. Oh. They have thought about a 3 and pass it up. Now to X. Looks down low to Murphy. Or makes that down low to B. Back to X. B. Or Holland drives the baseline. Wrap around pass to Pollock. B. In the paint. Layup. Good. 63-38.
Pollock now with 13.
Okay, thank you. Left side of Bedke. Fedke, middle of the floor, swings right side to Parrott. Here comes the double team. Parrott around the double team, gives the snap, now near side to Carter. Carter swings into the baseline to Fedke. Couple of dribbles around the defense to Carter. Carter, a couple of dribbles in the middle of the floor. Baseball pass right side to Parrott. Drives the baseline, throws up a shot over Pollock. No good. Holland to the rebound. Rochester runs 63-38 leaders. 5 minutes to play in the game. Hesitates, accelerates, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, short, gets her own rebound. Dribbles out of trouble in the paint again. And bounce pass top of the key to Stasiak, and Rochester resets. Stasiak backs it out. We'll set up the offense, gets a pick from Pollock, works to the right side, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, it's good!
Wow.
65-38 Rochester, 4:40 to play in the game. Carter around the defense, 15-foot jumper on the way, no good. Keaton with another rebound and runs. Stasiak ahead of the pack. Stasiak against Carter on the way, good and a foul! Whew. Is that called a continuation foul?
I believe so.
Yowza.
Manchester Paul, number 52,
so Rochester and Keaton Stasiak with an opportunity to push this lead to 30.
Stasiak now with 16.
4.5 to play in the game. Keaton ready. Eyes the free throw, lets it fly. It's good, nothing but net. 68-38. Rochester on top with 4.5 to play in the game. And, you know, we just mentioned to Brad that Coach Stasiak probably will go to his bench here shortly. And then Manchester throws to the backcourt. Keaton runs it down. Oh,
and travels.
And can't save it from going out of bounds. It was going to be Rochester basketball. Manchester picked it up. But, man, she just about got there.
I think she thought she could probably get an easy layup out of it because she'd already beat the Manchester players to the ball. But, unfortunately, she couldn't pick it up.
And I think that if she bends down and grabs it and gets it up, she's in for a layup. You're right. But she couldn't get it with her fingertips. 4:15 to play in the game. 30-point lead for Rochester. Carter on the baseline. One dribble. Now right side to Milam. High on the right side for Manchester. Now to Howard. Swings right side to Carter. Carter drives against Abbott. And she is fouled by doing so. And she'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
That's Abbott's second.
4:05 to play in the game. 68-38. Rochester on top.
Really like to see Murphy get a shot at a three before we pull her out of the game.
He's
got 27 right now. Let's just round those numbers off.
All right, that works for me. Second one on the way is good again. And Carter hits both of them to make it a 68-40 score. And, like we mentioned before, we're 4 minutes away from Coach Stasiak's 200th victory. Murphy for three, top of the key, too hard. Holland with the rebound. X on the wing. Left side. Now rings at the near side, looking for Pollock on the down of the block. Gets it down before she falls on the ground. Pollock puts it up, no good. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Murphy was right on. She had a little bit too much string.
A little long.
Yep.
And Betke is done. That's her fifth.
3:45 to play in the game. Rochester up by 28. And B. Pollock with an opportunity to push this back to 30.
Shooting two.
B. Eyes the first one. Lets it fly. Good. So I have one more. One more coming for the senior. Second one for B is in and out, no good. And the rebound to Snap. Snap gives the head to Parrott. Across the timeline left, bounce pass to Milam. Thinks about a three, gives on the baseline to Howard. Back to Milam, eight-footer, short. Murphy with another rebound.
She's got to be pushing a double-double
now. Yeah, that's what I was just going to think. Murphy misses B. Pollock wide open down low. Crossover dribble goes to the paint. Down low, great pass to Bailey Evans. She finishes with a layup. 3:15 to play in the game. Rochester by 31. Parrott high on the left side to Carter. Stands with the ball above her head. One dribble. Cut off. Down to Milam at the elbow left. Top of the key to Snap. Snap around the defense, and she is going to be fouled by Holland.
That'll be her third.
3 minutes to play in the game.
Alexa Holland.
Again, Rochester up 71-40. So Sydney Snip at the line to shoot one of the bonus for Manchester. Snap, right-handed free throw shooter. It's up, short, rebound to Stasiak. Keaton grabs the board and runs. Now picks it up, gives it to Murphy. Near the center circle, she drives it down low, wide open to Abbott. Her layup is good.
Another assist for Murphy and a bucket by Abbott.
Quickly up the floor of the Lady Squires. 2:45 to play in the game. Quickly to Milam. Her long jumper is short. Rebound tipped around. Stasiak rips it. And here comes two subs for Rochester, which means the two seniors' nights are coming to an end. Murphy dribbles with 2:25 to play in the game. Rochester up 73-40. Murphy works to the near side. Cut off by the defense. Out now to Stasiak. Stasiak holds. She's going to dribble. Does so. Out to Holland now. Wide open three for X. Yep. 76-40. 2 minutes to play in the game. Coach Stasiak looking down the bench. She's going to empty it. Parrott behind the arc. Top of key to Carter. And now we're going to have a Rochester, make that a Manchester timeout. It is a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, the seniors' nights are done, and what a performance by Carly Murphy. Finishes the game with 27 points.
And probably close to 10 rebounds and half a dozen assists.
Stasiak rips the board after the missed free throw, missed shot by Manchester. B. Pollock's going to finish tonight with 14 points, and Stasiak loses the basketball to bounds. 14 points and 7 boards. Murphy's going to finish with 27 points, 8 boards, and 5 assists.
All right.
Good heavens.
That's a pretty productive night.
Very, very good. A minute 40 to play in the game. Coach Tony Stasiak will pick up his 200th victory of his coaching career, all here at Rochester. Manchester with the basketball. Top key three for Snep is no good, and Stasiak's going to come over the back and foul.
Zebra Pollock, number 22, B. Pollock. Correction, that was called on number 12, Keaton Stasiak.
Well, they tried to give Keaton Stasiak's foul to B. Pollock last time. Well, not try, but they did, and they tried to do it again.
Bailey.
Selena. 1:28 to play in the game. Rochester by 36, and Carter will be at the line to shoot one and the bonus for her Lady Squires. Well, I guess we're going to be on the road again on Tuesday as we travel to John Glenn in the first round of the sectional. That's game number 2 at John Glenn, so we need to leave early, don't we?
Yeah, like 2.
Can you leave at 2?
If you say so. You got to feed me.
I always do.
Yeah.
Need more? Second one is good this time. 1 of 2 that time for Manchester Squires. 76-41. 1:20 to play in the game. Keaton Stasiak now the guard for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Works against Parrott. Works across the timeline. Now backs it back out to the free throw, or the 10-second line. Now in the center circle. Switches hands, crossover dribble, works right side, down the paint, pull-up jumper on the way, too hard, Abbott with the rebound, lost it out of bounds, they're going to say last touch by Manchester. And now Coach Stasiak will bring in Van Meter and Carpenter. Sir Ray Carpenter had 10 in the JV game today. Bailey Abbott's done, Keaton Stasiak had a fantastic night as well.
17 for Stasiak.
Odell will look to get it in, and Odell looking, gets it into Sir Ray, had it knocked out of bounds by Hacker, and Rochester will try it again. 68 seconds to play in the game. I think that Coach Stasiak ought to get the Gatorade bucket.
Is there one over there?
Yeah, but there's a lot of water bottles.
Yeah.
Van Meter feeds inside to Saray, has it picked off and stolen by Hacker. Hacker gets away with the carry, goes to the right side of the basket, throws up a shot. No good. Rebound tipped away. Steph has it in the lane, has it stripped away from her, and gets it back from Gillum. She loses it. Gillum has it, throws up a shot off the window. No good. Ball being tipped around. Saray Carpenter comes out of there with it. Now to Van Meter. 45 seconds of play in the game. 76-41 Rochester. Van Meter works right side to Hyatt. Maddie Hyatt in the lane. Throws up a shot partially blocked. Ball being tipped around. Hacker comes out of there with it with 30. Hacker will walk it through the center circle for Manchester with 25. Gives him the baseline to Gillum. Her foot on the line. Jumper, long jumper, no good. Maddie Hyatt with a rebound. Hyatt runs with 20. Dribbles away from Snep. Down to 17. Maddie Hyatt works left side against Gillum with 14. Now gives to Van Meter, and Rochester turns it over on the over and back with 12. 76-41. Rochester on top, and now Manchester will bring in some subs.
Checking in with the Squires, number 12, Kelly Milo.
12.3 to play in the game. Rochester going to finish the regular season at 15-4.
52, Sierra Carter.
Carter runs against Garrison. Jeez, Garrison just ran over a Milam on the pick. Good heavens. Well, when you don't communicate, that's what happens.
Yeah, if you don't know it's coming.
Alexa Garrison.
9 seconds of play in the game. 76-41.
Number 12, Ellie Milam.
Rochester, not a whole lot of time to enjoy this one as John Glenn on the horizon. I'm not even sure Tony will. He will, just for the seniors. But he'll start thinking about John Glenn immediately after this game.
Right. You're right.
And we'll have a pretty intense walkthrough, I'm guessing, on Monday. Second free throw, no good. Saray Carpenter rips the board and gives to Garrison with 6. Now off to Van Meter with 4, with 3, with 2, with 1, and that'll do it. The final tonight, the Rochester Lady Zebras defeat the Manchester Squires 76-42. Coach Stasiak picks up his 200th victory in his coaching career, and the seniors go out with a bang. Post-game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.